guys, welcome back to the Supes channel. My name is Matthew Ramos, and on this channel I am to entertain, inform, and inspire using the topic of discussion as always, which is superheroes. So guys, big video, I repeat, big video, because in today's video we're going to be breaking down an entire plot leak regarding Marvel's Disney Plus series WandaVision. Now guys, keep in mind that this WandaVision series is going to lead directly into Doctor Strange, the Multiverse of Madness, which is looking to be one of the biggest Marvel movies they've ever made, because this is going to be Doctor Strange into the Multiverse of Madness is going to be the biggest world building movie that Marvel has ever put out. So this is going to, that movie in itself, it's going to lay the groundwork for what's to come for the future of the MCU. That's why we have series like WandaVision, Loki, all being connected to this film. And that's why us as fans, we're gonna have to watch Loki and WandaVision to understand what's going to happen in Doctor Strange and the Multiverse of Madness. But in today's video, we got a huge plot leak regarding the full plot for Marvel's WandaVision. And guys, it involves the return of Ultron. I need to get into this already. So guys, make sure to stay to the end of the video for giveaway details. And without further ado, let's get right into the plot leak regarding WandaVision. So with the release of Disney Plus finally launching earlier this week, a huge plot leak has come up for WandaVision. So the description reads, after the events of Avengers Endgame, Wanda is depressed and homeless. A mysterious woman named Agatha comes across Wanda and offers her a deal. Agatha can make a pocket dimension of the perfect world for Wanda, as long as she stays there forever, and Wanda agrees. Wanda's perfect world consists of Vision with her, two newborn babies, Wiccan and Speed. Agatha appears as a noisy neighbor to keep an eye out on Wanda as she plans to kill her after the two babies grow up, which they do in the span of a week. In the main MCU dimension, on Earth, FBI agent Jimmy Woo, with his recruiters Darcy Lewis from the Thor movies and Monica Rambeau from Captain Marvel, are hired to solve the case regarding Agatha, where they get sucked into Wanda's pocket dimension. Guest stars and cameos including Lashana Lynch as an elderly Maria using CGI, James Spader as Ultron with archive footage from 2015's Age of Ultron, and Benedict Cumberbatch as Doctor Strange. The final episode of the series will lead into Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness. Dick Van Dyke and Carol Burnett were offered cameo roles of an elderly couple in Wanda's perfect world. Ben Barnes and Dominic West are cast as Scython and the Grim Reaper, Agatha's two minions who are tasked to kill Vision and the babies. This is huge news regarding how the series will connect to Doctor Strange 2 as the events unfold in bad ways. So as we got a lot to break down in this plot leak, and you know, just from beginning to end, this is something we need to take with a grain of salt, although we should expect the core elements of this plot leak to be in the actual series for the show. I mean, from beginning to end, this just all makes so much sense. After the events of Avengers Endgame, what is Wanda gonna do? Wanda doesn't have anyone. She doesn't have the Avengers. She doesn't have Vision. She doesn't have anyone. So it makes sense to be this homeless, depressed, just completely broken down character. And then this woman, this mysterious woman, Agatha, comes to her, offering her a life in a pocket dimension. The dimensions. This is what connects to Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness. And this also explains how this show is going to be filmed as a sitcom for the first half of the show. In this pocket dimension, Wanda is going to be living her dream life with Vision and Wiccan and Speed, the two babies. And you know, within this pocket dimension, this is how it's going to be filmed in a sitcom style series. After it was announced that this show is going to be partially sitcom, a lot of us were wondering how is that Marvel show going to be in a sitcom style? But now this makes sense. This all explains it, because in Wanda's perfect world, it's going to be her being a housewife with Vision and raising their two babies, Wiccan and Speed. And I wouldn't be surprised if towards the end of this series, we get to see Wiccan and Speed go with Wanda to the back to the main dimension of the MCU. But this just, with Doctor Strange cameoing in this series, it just makes so much sense, because now with Agatha, offering Wanda, this mysterious woman, Agatha, offering Wanda a life in its separate dimension. Now we're in the territory of different dimension, alternate realities, and this is exactly what Doctor Strange is an expertise in. And this is why he's going to get involved, and this is why he's going to cameo in this series. And within Wanda's perfect pocket dimension world, we are going to see Ultron. Ultron, it was confirmed in this plot leak that we are going to see Ultron. He's going to be like this little separate entity, but he's not going to be a big, he's not going to be the main villain. Agatha is obviously the main villain of this series, but Ultron is going to be present within this series, and it makes sense because the whole, you know, Wanda's story started with Ultron. Her entire involvement with the Avengers, the creation of Vision, all of that began with her connection to Ultron. So it would make sense for us to see Ultron appear in this series. And then, you know, it doesn't have to be a big thing because they could just use archived, you know, pieces of dialogue from 2015's Avengers Age of Ultron. But the fact that Ultron is going to be coming back in some form of another, although he might not be playing a main role, this leaves the possibilities open to him returning to the main dimension of the MCU. Because if we're dealing with multiple dimensions and Wanda hopping from multiple dimensions, then why can't Ultron do the same? Why can't he hop from Wanda's pocket dimension back into the main MCU timeline? So this is just absolutely insane territory that we're getting into. And this is going to be completely, so utterly important for the future of the MCU as Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness. This is what possibly could set up the introduction of Deadpool, the Fantastic Four, the X-Men. But judging off of how this plot leak ended, it looks as if Doctor Strange is going to enter Wanda's pocket dimension, get her out of there, and that's how we're going to see those two transfer in directly to Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness, because we do know that Wanda is going to be Doctor Strange's sidekick in Doctor Strange 2. So I just see it happening so easily after the end of the series. You know, Wanda has to leave her perfect pocket dimension world, and she's going to have to go with Doctor Strange as her, you know, her playing around with different dimensions, that has caused a huge rift within the actual multiverse. And if it really ends how it looks like it's going to end, with Wanda leaping over to another dimension alongside Doctor Strange, it just gets me thinking, what if at the end of Doctor Strange 2, we get to see Deadpool enter the main MCU dimension? We get to see him hopping from different dimensions, and that's how he gets connected into the main MCU timeline. You know, they don't have to throw in the old Fox X-Men cast, because they're never going to play their characters. Those actors are never going to reprise those roles again. But Ryan Reynolds is going to come back as Deadpool. And what if at the end of Doctor Strange and the Multiverse of Madness, we see Deadpool hop over from a different dimension to the main MCU timeline? So guys, this plot leak gave us a ton, basically the whole plot for WandaVision, the whole plot, how it's going to connect to Doctor Strange and the Multiverse of Madness, how Ultron is going to be involved within the series, and oh my god, like this just explains everything for us, because after Avengers Endgame, we don't really know how Wanda, where she's going to go, but now it all makes 100% total sense. It makes sense how this is going to be a sitcom style for a part of the series. It explains how it's going to connect to Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness. It explains how Vision is going to come back. It explains how we're going to get to see Wiccan and Speed. It explains everything. So let me know in the comment section down below what you guys think of the full plot leak for Marvel's WandaVision. Now getting into giveaway details, guys, I'm giving away a PlayStation 4 in December. All you have to do to enter this giveaway is like this video, comment down below, and subscribe for an entry towards winning a PlayStation 4. So guys, not only did we get a full plot leak for WandaVision explaining literally everything and how this series is going to connect to Doctor Strange and the Multiverse of Madness, but this opens up the idea of dimension hopping. And when we really put that into perspective, this is how Deadpool is going to enter the MCU, baby. And I have no doubt in my mind that the end credits scene for Doctor Strange and the Multiverse of Madness, we're going to get to see Ryan Reynolds' Deadpool hop from his dimension over to the main MCU dimension, the same way Wanda came from the MCU dimension and went to her own little fantasy pocket dimension that Agatha created for her. So let me know in the comment section down below what you guys think of that. And guys, again, hit that bell notification on my channel to get notified when I post these videos so like that you can get informed of what's to come for the future of Marvel. So thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys next time.